purpose of this video is to illustrate how to use CODAP Sampler to generate data from a model. In the top menu, click on Plugins and select Sampler. Here we see a collection of objects in a mixer that we can edit. You can imagine this mixer as a hat with pieces of paper in it. I can add objects using the plus button. If I've added too many, I can use the minus button to remove them. Let's say I want to simulate a situation of a carnival duck pond game that has a collection of rubber ducks in a pond where 20% of the ducks are marked on their belly for a prize. If a player picks one of these marked floating ducks, they win a prize. Once a duck is picked, it is returned to the pond and the booth operator swirls them around in the pond to mix them up. The booth owners expect about 50 students to play the game at the carnival. Each player pays $1 to pick 3 ducks, one at a time with replacement. I can create 10 objects, 2 objects to represent winning ducks, which I will label as prize, and 8 to represent blank ducks, which I will label as no. We are using 10 objects with 2 labeled prize to model the situation of having 20% ducks labeled in the pond. If we click on Spinner, we can see how the same distribution from the mixer is represented in a spinner model. These options up here allow me to choose my sample size in addition to how many times I run the simulation. The default option in the sampler is that objects are chosen with replacement. If you're modeling a scenario that includes without replacement, you can change that under this Options tab. Also take note of the Hide Model option, which might be helpful if you are a teacher and don't want your students to see the model you have created. I can ask myself the question, after randomly choosing 3 ducks, what are the chances of winning a prize for all 3? I can test this out by simulating to see about how many prizes would be won in this scenario. First, I'll simulate a round of the game where one player picks 3 ducks, so I'll change the default 5 items to 3. For now, I will simulate playing the game 6 times, so I will collect 6 samples and press Start. You will see that an object is randomly selected 3 times and that this process is repeated 6 times. In addition, a table automatically starts to populate with the results of my simulation. It is in the form of a hierarchical table. On the outermost level of the table, I see that so far I have only run 1 experiment. In the next level, I see that I have taken 6 samples. And in the final level, I see the results of the 6 samples I took, 3 values from the first, 3 values from the second, and so on. If I click on sample 2, for example, all 3 results from that sample are highlighted. I can now graph the results of my simulation by creating a graph and dragging value to the x-axis. I can also separate my results by which sample they belong to by dragging sample to the y-axis. Now I'm going to run this simulation many more times, and to speed up the process, I can change the speed setting to fastest. I'm going to collect 44 more samples. It becomes clear to me that this graph is not so helpful anymore, but I can use the table to calculate a measure that may be more helpful to me. If I want to calculate how many prizes students got in each simulated round of play, I can add an attribute at the sample level by clicking on this plus sign. I click on the attribute to edit the formula and count the number of times prize appears in each sample. Now let's graph this new attribute. Notice that I can change this attribute to be treated as categorical and change it into a bar graph. And I notice that none of the students got 3 prizes during 50 rounds of play. That was a brief introduction to one way of using the sampler, which is to generate your own data using a model. Another way is to sample data from an existing data set of population data. Here I have already opened a very large data set of movies, which contains over 5,000 movies and lots of information on each case or each movie. The data set is from data.world and was compiled by scraping information from the online movie database IMDb. I'm going to treat this data set as a population, even though realistically it is missing movies. Let's say I want to take a sample of these movies to approximate the average length of movies. So I've opened the sampler again, and this time I'm using the collector tool. My data set is already populated in the collector, and each case is represented by an object. I can also choose other collections here if they are available. I want to sample 45 movies from my population, so I've changed the 5 to a 45. And I want to do this 5 times. I've clicked Start, but sometimes when sampling from a large collection, it may take a few seconds for cases to be sampled and for the table to populate. Now that my 5 samples of 45 movies each have been taken, I can now graph movie duration. And in order to see what the distribution looks like for each sample, I can separate by sample. I can display the mean, and I can start to see the variability in the means between samples. This is a brief introduction to how to use the sampler to collect samples from a data set.